Hi, Jeff Weinstein here. You know how there are some people who seem like they were just born to communicate? They're so natural, so confident, they can inspire anyone to do anything? Well, there are people like that out there, but there are a lot more people out there who struggle to communicate. I hear the same stories over and over again. Stories of frustration with emails that get no response, sales proposals that don't sell, and of course those PowerPoint presentations that literally put people to sleep. Now, I could go on with this list for a while, but why do we listen to some people and completely ignore others? Well, the answer has to do with the way we make decisions in our hearts and our minds. If you've ever bought a home, you'll recall that magic moment when you knew you wanted that house. Was it when you saw the kitchen, or the big backyard, or maybe the jacuzzi tub? Whatever your decision point was, I'm gonna bet that you remember it vividly because it was emotional. Now, of course, you still had to get financing, you still had to get a home inspection, but these logical steps kicked in later after you'd already made the emotional decision. Now, the same rule applies if you want people to listen to you at work. You have to engage their hearts before you try to convince their minds. Yet in business, we're taught to do the exact opposite. Stick to the facts, be professional, and by all means, keep those emotions out of it. Think about that 5-page proposal that forced you through all the background detail before you even got to the recommendation. And we wonder why business communications are so painful. Instead of drawing people in, we're burying them under a pile of detail that they care nothing about. Now, I'm not saying that business communication should be dramatic, and I'm certainly not saying that you should wear your heart on your sleeve at work. But good communication touches the human spirit. It taps into that raw magnetic power that makes people want to take action. And that's what influence is all about. So what does being more influential mean to you and your team? Well, you're gonna notice a lot of changes. People are gonna start paying attention to you when you speak. They're gonna look to you for leadership. If you're in sales, they're gonna give you more business. In fact, they're gonna do almost anything you ask because good communicators are so rare. Those natural, confident people I talked about earlier, they're not born that way. They're made. And if you're ready to transform the way you communicate, I'd love to chat. Check out my website or give me a call.